This is a Danger Entertainment podcast.
Hello, it's Velda here, Velda Gameblight. Well, I suppose you must like the podcast because you've been, well, you're listening now, unless you've just skipped the end, in which case do go back to the beginning. Maybe not the beginning, because that's when they burnt my tent. I like that tent. It's not just like you can go to a shop and buy a new tent. Although you can do that, but I didn't want to, because it was a good tent, and I was very fond of it. And anyway, I think I've gone off the point. Thanks for listening, and apparently we're on Podbean, Spotify, and iTunes, and Discord, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and Tumblr, whatever they are. Probably something degenerate.
Previously on the Danger Club podcast.
Any chance you can armor a monkey?
We can make you some monkey armor.
Can I make an animal handling check to see if he wants to start a gang with me? How would a natural one do on that?
You
situation?
Are now in a gang war with Philippe. You see a large vessel approaching.
I shall look.
A third eye opens on Beelzebub's forehead.
Oh, my weird!
I've not told you this, but I had a son.
You begin to approach Absalom.
I mean, obviously, I'm going to help him out, just, you know, because that's important.
Shinar gives him a hug.
Oh, all right.
The adventure continues now.
On the last cookies that James made for us all.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, because I made 7.
They were really good cookies, weren't they?
They were really good, because there was one for Drummond, and one for Ross, and one for Colin, yep. And I had one,
you
and Scott had one.
So, hang on,
and
not,
then Holly had one, and then... Where's the seventh cookie?
Where's the one that we saved for Scott?
Where's the seventh cookie?
Where is that? What? Oh, I mean, I was really...
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the cookie-filled Danger Club podcast.
Oh, Dan. What is that down your gilet?
In your mouth.
Are they cookie crumbs down your gilet?
I don't know what you mean.
What?
You monster!
You
there
honestly
seven
think
cookies on that plate? There are six of us.
I handmade.
Holly was here for like a whole 2 hours, man.
You forgot my wife, and you ate my cookie.
I think the rest of this podcast needs to be Drum and Scott killing Dad.
Every podcast is so nearly that.
On another note, I'd like to make a big shout out to our big old hourglass. Well done, Colin. It is actually working quite well.
It's working
well,
isn't it?
Yeah,
I think it is.
And it's pink, which matches my eyes.
Where'd you get it from? Where did I get it? I got it from this little known retailer. It's like a little thrift store.
I wish you were going to say this little wise woman. And she was travelling through and like, selling charms. Do you have an hourglass?
It was called Amazon.
Big up, yeah.
Amazon. Wow.
She is amazing. She has lots of stuff in her. Yeah, her stuff. Although I hear she pays her little elves nothing.
Apparently so, yeah.
And she never pays tax.
Who are we to judge? Who Jeff Bezos does actually do that really well.
Yeah.
Who are we to judge? Big up Amazon. Or Amazon.
Hey, when did you sell out? What? You get corporate sponsorship. Is that where you get everything delivered?
Totally
goes. Boss has just got drones delivering him everything he needs right now. He's like a weird.
I wish I had a drone for the takeaway I just ordered. That took an hour. Anyway,
I mean, given your purchases, next week you will have a drone for your takeaway.
Yes, I will. Thank you.
To go with your many, many toys, Jeff.
That was lovely.
He's already got a drone. I bought him a drone.
I did.
I think we spoke about it on the podcast before that I ruined Chloe's fossil with it.
Oh yeah, that's right.
So what was it? She said survived 50 million years and 5 seconds with Ross Hart.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah.
Oh no.
Yep.
Oh well. Speaking of fossils, Dan.
What?
Yeah.
Like he's the oldest one in the room.
Which he isn't.
He's not.
I'm the lower half of that, thank you very much. Although it does not seem like that at all. At least I don't have a cardigan on today. How dare you, sir? How dare you? I have neither eaten your cookie nor forgotten your wife today. I am not in your bed.
He's getting to you next week.
Next week,
there'll be a murdered shepherd in your backstory. As if by magic.
Or your drones will be downed.
No, I'll just kill Fulton off. I'll just kill Fulton off.
Yeah, because Fulton's away now. He's no longer with the protection of the Danger Club, so what can happen to him and Nomala?
Yeah. He is at the whims of the storyteller, so he could just be like, oh yeah, and Fulton's dead. So anyway, moving on.
You receive a letter, it just says, Fulton's dead, sad face.
Sad face did this. God damn it, we must find Sad Face.
It's gonna avenge him.
We've talked before about that comic book run early doors with Batman and Robin, and they made the listeners write in if they wanted Robin to survive this particularly harrowing experience. Yeah, and no one liked that particular incarnation of Robin, so he died to the Joker in a warehouse via crowbar.
Oh, explosion. Yeah, yeah.
Really horrible. It was like a 1-800 number, wasn't it? It was like, dial this number to kill Jason Todd.
So that's what you can do with Fulton. If you prefer, Beelzeboob, then, you know, tell us, let us know. And yeah. Or even maybe don't kill him. Just for gas.
Imagine.
Just for some shits and giggles.
Hashtag kill Fulton.
I am, of course, joking. We wouldn't do that. If you prefer Fulton, that's fine. We'll kill Beelzeboob instead. Like, it's, we don't bonded that well with him yet. He still creeps us out. So we could just all murder him on the deck of this boat if you want.
And no, Bubba likes
it. However, keep jam.
If you do have any Pacific opinions, you can call 0800-121-SCREW.
Pacific. Pacific opinions.
Pacific opinions.
You want opinions on a particular ocean?
Yeah. Should we drown Fulton in the Pacific? hey, you wanted. No.
Yes! No.
Come on, James, what are we going to say?
No. I was going to say Pacifics, but it's all a gag on what everybody might miss. Yeah, exactly. That's why I stopped.
Are you heckling yourself, James?
I'm having some sort of pun seizure, I think. So, could my magic powers be finally running out? Ooh, I don't know.
Don't know. Have you got any more cookies kicking around?
No. However, there's a cupcake there. You could eat that, Dan.
Dan's just sitting on a pile of like confectionery, like Jeff Bezos sitting on his pile of gold.
Ross, put that knife down, all right?
Oh, what did you say?
You are insulting the Bezos.
You may not have forgotten Ross's wife, but you forgot Ross's knife.
Yeah. You're an Absalom.
Yes.
Well, we're not there yet, are we? We're coming up the island.
You are approaching
very close.
The Isle of Quartos.
Very close. The Isle of Quartos.
Yes.
So we're still sailing, coming up to the
close heart to hearts on that little journey around half the world.
Although, it was interesting.
We are sailing to Absalom in the night. We are sailing.
It's hard for five people to improvise one song, isn't it?
It really is. Yeah, it really is.
I don't know if you've noticed that, Dangerlings, but we all do sing different things. We got Absalom there, which I was so proud of that we all did.
Absalom, it's a bomb.
People already ask us if we're Flintlocks and Fireballs frenemies without us adding in nautical songs to our podcast as well.
Big up Flintlocks.
I was going to say though, the reminiscence about Fulton, I thought would go on for longer because we've had reminiscences before when everyone sort of said the little thing about that. We just sort of moved on really quick. It's like, Fulton.
We need to move on. He's not dead. That's what I'm finding odd about it. Like, we're not grieving him.
He's not dead. He's left the team.
He's left the team.
He's coming back though.
Literally, and wasn't the saying Danger Club for Life said only a few episodes ago?
Yeah,
and then Fulton literally goes the next episode. Yeah, Danger Club for Life. Laters.
We've got to do an intro, haven't we? Of like Bad Boy for Life, but Danger Club for Life. Like,
Danger Club. What, like Danger Club? Danger Club. What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do when we come for you?
No, that's Bad Boy.
Roll a natural one.
Yeah, which is Bad Boy for Life.
This song by Puff Daddy.
Oh, I thought you said
Don't
Bad Boys.
Try and out knowledge Colin on this subject. You know,
it's also a film that's just come out, right?
The hip hop, James. Is it the hip hop?
Hip hop, the house of beats.
Those hippity hoppers.
Yeah.
Which hip was it? Was it Lindy Hop or
absolutely delightful? So what's the plan? Now you finally made it to Absalom.
Just to get there.
What's
have some sandwiches that aren't mouldy.
Get to the docks.
We're gonna go see the Pathfinders and for some reason the Arcanists in the Arcanium. I don't know about that.
I'm not sure about that at all. I think we should just go and see the Pathfinders.
That's actually my bad because I did forget that I suggested that we shouldn't go anywhere near any sort of powerful magicians. And then was like, we're looking for people of powerful arcana. Pathfinders.
It's not the place to go, but
what?
But yeah, we have to go to the Arcanium.
Why do we have to go there?
Why?
Because that's where they learn all the arcana stuff.
Yeah, we don't want to go there.
Because we're carrying an incredibly powerful magic artifact. If we show it to any incredibly powerful,
do you remember we had a whole conversation about
I'm from Nex. So, like,
we don't need trousers, mate.
Nex is not in Absalom.
They never fit very well.
No, but there's people that are from Nex there.
Big up Nex.
So, but why? We only need to go see the Pathfinder.
Okay, I'm just saying.
Why? What?
I just know peeps, yeah?
Giving loaders really random information.
I just know peeps.
Passive aggressive trying to get us to go to a place we don't need to go to.
I know peeps.
Yeah, but okay. that doesn't mean we're not going to go there.
I know peeps.
Okay, cool. Jeff Bezos. When we go to the Arcanium, we burn it to the ground.
No, we're going to see the Pathfinders. We all agreed on that. ages ago. That's
even
what we're
then,
gonna do, right?
Even then, I think we should be cautious with our trust. As
exactly.
Well. Let's be on full guard. Which is actually quite interesting because Fulton was the worst at that. I'm just going to wander in and tell you our sole secret plan. It's like, oh, great. Cool. So we're glad that
Fulton's gone. Is that what you're...
In this situation, he might have been a liability. I'm saying that.
Okay.
If we're trying to keep something secret,
that is
Fulton
one
was...
vote for kill Fulton.
Yeah. What do you think, Angelings?
Is it to be drowning in the Pacific? Or is he safe?
But there's lots of other things you could do. You're in the largest city in the world that you have arrived now. So you've got a lot of places you could track down. We know that there is one of the franchise of Beelzeboobs and was it Beelzeboobs Bits and Boobs?
Yeah.
Right. Beelzeboobs Bits and Bobs.
I've got a question.
Run by Boom Bang Bang.
Bang.
Bang, boom, boom.
Bang, bam, bang, bam.
Boom. Bang, bang,
bang, bang, bang.
Yeah, yeah. Right. Rock. I've got a quick question, though. obviously, there were some runes being used in that last episode. And just for the listeners who don't know much about runes, what is this? You just get a rune and stick it on a bit of armor, bit
apparently,
of weapon,
yeah,
and it
like,
just boosts it to max?
You know,
I mean,
like
why haven't we done this before?
You're not boosting it. Well, yeah, it depends on it's either weapon or armor enhancement. You know, like in other games where you can get, like, you know, a patch like to enhance your armor. They have them in The Witcher and stuff, don't they? There's like other RPGs that do it as well.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it seems that way, although you can't do it yourself. Obviously, in some games, you can just be like, I know this, so zap, but you've got to go get it done.
Did I hear you saying it was like 25 gold?
Well, you can do it yourself if you're trained in crafting and if you put the points into crafting and you have like a forge or you have access to it. So you could have a dedicated party crafter who makes, and you can make runes from scratch and put them onto weapons. But yeah, you can take the runes are transferable. So you can remove them from weapons and you can put them onto weapons.
Very
and you may occasionally find something called a rune stone, which is just a rune being transported, basically. So you can just take that stone, add it to a weapon, and that weapon then has that property.
Right.
So it means that you're no longer just like, oh, this is my +1 flaming sword, and that's all that will ever be. It's like, that's what this is. I could name this sword if I want, because I know I can add another rune stone to it later and I can make it better and it can level up with me. Or I could take the flaming rune off it and put it onto a different thing.
How many? What's the capacity on runestones per item?
It depends on how high quality the item is. You have fundamental runes, which are like the plus runes, basically the ones that increase your bonus to hit, and the striking rune. The fundamental ones, you need higher level ones of those to allow you to take other runes like flaming and stuff like that. So you have to kind of upgrade the basic stuff, and then you can add fancy stuff on top of that.
Interesting.
There's a lot of fancy stuff you can do with weapons, and then there are kind of named items and things which are much as they were in first edition.
And I think, because I asked this question, but I don't know if it's on air, I think it's off air, you can add runes to things like just cloth robes.
Yes.
Yeah.
You can add armor runes to those, so you might be able to increase your armor class. Because there aren't stuff like rings of protection in second edition. That was one of the things with second edition was like, let's get rid of all these items that you sort of have to have, like the cloak of resistance, the ring of protection, the things like... basically ones that just add some numbers to your stats, and everyone basically has to have them or you're not an effective character, because it's just about getting your number really, really high and getting your armor class insanely high, and it means it's kind of like at high levels armor class is fairly meaningless, because every monster has to have such a high to hit to be able to have a chance of beating the stupid armor class you have by that point from all of the special magic and items you have, that really they hit you all the time, and it's just about having the most hit points possible to try and survive it. So it's all about trying to keep the numbers down a little bit and trying to keep the essential items down, so you got a bit more when you take items. It's more because you like them, because they have some flavor, rather than because they're just mathematically something you need to make your build work.
Cool. And it did make the scythe look super, super badass as well.
Oh yeah.
I mean, if that's not a reason to get runes, I don't know what is. Who doesn't like runes?
How many could I have on my leather studded armor?
How many could you have on your leather studded armor? You can only have one armor rune.
Okay.
And then you can have an armor property rune. So you can have a rune that will do something to it other than that. So you could have two runes on it. But you can upgrade the rune. So at the moment you've got a level one. So it's a +1 bonus. But you could get a rune that is slightly more powerful. It will give you a +2 bonus, something like that.
Okay.
So you can do that. And those are available for purchase.
Mm. If you got runes and put them on a goggle, would that give you a rune with a view?
Oh, he's back, yo.
I'm back.
So
that's me cracking.
You have had a very...
Don't shake your head at me, Scott Wilson Begrove, a.k.a. Wolfgang Logophile Hemingway.
Shake my head. It's just the lack
shave
of...
Shave your head. You did not shave your head because I make puns.
I made a joke and I shaved my head.
The first time you made a pun, I shaved my head and I will not grow my hair back until you cannot make any puns anymore.
Do you shave your head at me, sir?
Swear it by these shaved-headed runes.
So, the city at the centre of the world, Absalom. Captain Gumbo's boat, the Rusty Button, approaches the great city. And moors up in one of the little ports, just a little way outside of the main city itself. Absalom is huge. Like, Kermargo was big, but Absalom is. And the fact that it's not enclosed means that you can see it just spread out across the fields in front of you. Just houses and buildings as far as the eye can see. You can see a few tall things in various points. You can see the spire of Nex even from here. It's a mile tall. You can see it's to the north of the main city. You can see it rising up into the sky outside of the main city. But then there are lots of small villages and farms, and it's like a modern city. If you fly into a modern city and you see that it's sort of, you get your suburbs and then it gets denser and denser, and in the center it's just buildings everywhere and tall buildings. So this is a big place.
Never seen the like it.
Yes, it's impressive, isn't it?
Extraordinary.
Wow. Yeah.
I wouldn't have believed it possible unless I saw it with my own eyes.
Because I don't think, other than Beelzeboob, none of you have been here before, have you? None of you have been. I don't think any of you have been this far south, even.
And this is definitely, I certainly haven't. And this is definitely by far the biggest city I'll ever see in my life. And Velda's very much aware of this and just is basically standing agog, muttering to himself, going, oh my God.
Beelzeboob, what are you doing? Are you
just
trying to hold my hand?
No,
I don't mind, but I just felt weird.
I will hold your hand, Uncle Velda.
All right.
He holds your hand. Jam holds your hand.
I just hold his hand.
He goes,
oh.
I hold it gently.
It's sort of soft. Sticky.
I feel really
warmer
sorry
than it should be.
Jam. Initially I was horrified, but it's just gone to sympathy and sorrow now. The poor little fellow.
Now, we need to go and get a place to stay, don't we, really? So, where should we go, Beelzeboob, my man?
There are lots of places that we can acquire inns. We should probably avoid the coin district, the coins, it's called.
Is it made? Is it made entirely and exclusively of coins that slide around when you stand around on them?
Do they throw buckets of coins from the windows? Does it rain coins?
Is it because there's no coins there?
No, none of those. But a lot of the people who are trying to avoid the city guards end up down there, and they are very nasty people.
So these are the bankers and things, yeah?
No, not really. Just so some people hide there.
So the city guard don't police the coin district?
Well, they try. Well, it's a huge city, and there are rough areas in all cities.
Okay, so what you're saying is the coin district is a rough area.
Yes.
But
the paddles also are also a little bit dangerous.
Thanks for
the paddles, the paddles.
The paddles are where people hide as well, because the city guard don't venture around there because in the case of it being...
Okay, so where does the city guard hang out so it will be nice and safe for us to go and get a place?
I will... you see, the...
Are we avoiding the city guard?
It's a place where there will be lots of them.
If you want, we can stay in the foreign quarter. That is where the Grand Lodge is.
Hey, Philippe.
What's the Grand Lodge of the Pathfinders?
Yes.
Okay, Philippe. Sounds great. Let's go there.
Philippe.
Philippe stares at you.
Philippe, hey, I know we've got a turf war going on. You take the Puddle District, I'll take the Coin District. Is that fair? Stay away from each other's turf, is that right?
Philippe looks sidelong at Shania and then nods sagely.
Unspoken agreement. Right. gang.
He tosses his flick knife in the air and catches it.
I catch a comb that I don't use because I'm bald.
Yes, let us go to the foreign quarter. That is where the Pathfinder Lodge is.
Sounds good.
And we could stay somewhere down there.
Let's go.
Yes.
Yeah, this is fair. Let's go.
So we head to the foreign quarter. Okay.
I'm going to make sure the boat is safe, but I will find somewhere. I will find out where you are and come stay with you later, if that's okay.
Yeah,
of course.
I mean, but, why?
I thought, would
you want
together
to stay with your boat and guard your boat?
We've been together all these months, and I thought we'd.
Felder, he's one of us now, yeah?
But surely he wants to guard his boat.
Yeah, I'm sure his boat will be fine.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, all right.
I just thought after all these times, you know? You were asleep, me standing by your side, just keeping you safe. And, and that meant we were close.
Mm.
You know, every...
so cold! Alright, well, you know,
no, it's
take
I mean,
along.
Alright, I guess
we'll be in the puddle district.
Somewhere.
No, I'm joking. Right, fine, alright.
No, don't go to the puddle district, there's some really unsavory monkeys run that place. I wouldn't go near there, mate.
Okay. Right, shall we? Oh, wait, are we more...
just step off the boat. A mile out from shore.
Yeah. Are we moored up?
You are, yes, you're moored up.
I'm eager to go and explore the city. I don't know about you.
Yeah. Okay, so we go to the foreign district. Leeds of A.
What time of day is it?
So it is the afternoon.
Afternoon, right.
Hey, Beelzeboob.
Yes.
Is it Beelzeboob or Beelzeboob?
Beelzeboob.
Beelzeboob. Where's the Absalom's like finest theatre or circus or both or cabaret?
Yeah, if you want to go to the circus.
Is that a tour guide you keep pulling out of your pocket?
Can you give us a walking tour?
I thought you'd been to the city before.
Yeah, I thought this was all a map in your mind.
The Ivy District is where you want to go. The home of all the theatres and impressive things like that.
Vaudeville and drag.
Yeah, there'd probably be some...
Do you reckon?
Yes. Crap. You could be famous in here if you were a good performer.
Hang on a moment, Beelzeboob.
Yes?
But we could have just taken that tourist guide and left you behind. I mean, if that's the source of all your knowledge.
No, it's not. It's just my notes. My alchemical notes.
What, do you read to see if there's a drag act in town?
No, just looking up some formulas.
You're doing the Larry David thing where he like looks at people.
Definitely noted.
Okay. Yes, if you want, you can go there now.
No, I think we should find somewhere to stay first.
Somewhere to stay. Is there a nice inn?
In your alchemical notes, is there anywhere nice to stay?
Yes.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're going to the foreign cause.
No,
fuck. What is wrong with this fucking team? She storms off to the foreign quarter.
I meant in the foreign quarter. The foreign quarter looks massive.
Bubba chases after Shania.
Caragor chases after Bubba.
I mean, I just sort of walk after them, puffing slightly.
Yeah.
Wait.
You are separated in the crowds and never find each other again. You have to put out a tannoy.
Yeah, but
always hold hands.
But the fuck?
Shania, what's going on?
I want to get to the place.
I know, so do I. But, like, I know it's frustrating. And we're still trying to gel as a team. We've got a new member. We're not even sure if they're a member yet. Do you know what I mean? But we can't storm away from each other. Because we need
that's
to.
That's what I do, that's how it brings the team together. I storm the fuck off, and then everyone follows me. I mean, that's how I do it.
Admittedly, it works, but we might be further away from like where we're.
That's okay, they all catch up. Hello, you all catch up, yes?
I mean, I've caught up with the other two, don't seem very interested, so.
We're catching up, but I'm not like running hard to catch up. But like,
I'm, however,
falling and threading through the ground.
I'm a bit like an apex predator, so I can use your tracking and scent. But even for me, it's quite hard to catch you in the. I mean, if we get properly separated, then. I mean, that's a. That's actual worry, so...
But Shania, I agree. Yeah, we should team.
Okay.
We should kind of, like, make some decisions and stick to them, do you know what I mean?
We made the decisions, we're going, yeah?
Caragor, where are you? I've lost you a bit in the crowd. I'm by the fruit seller.
I'll just get me Rancier out and I'll stick it in there. All right. Can you see that pointed?
Yes, there it is. Yeah. Right. Yeah. I'm coming.
All right. Sorry, I've got people looking at me now. So
there's a lot of people here, isn't there?
Yeah. Well, I'm going to put the Rancier away.
Oh,
sorry.
I've lost you again.
What, really?
Yes. I was following the.
God, you are inept.
No,
I'll stick the Rancier in there again.
All right. Fine.
This is exactly like being at a festival. Like, we have had this situation.
Yeah, we have.
The foreign quarter is the most cosmopolitan part of Absalom. There are creatures of all different ancestries moving around in the streets. It is like entering a sort of Star Wars kind of town. There's lots of creatures all over as you make your way past a huge Iruksi, so a huge lizard folk, carrying some boards over his shoulder, sort of stops and goes, and then steps aside for you to go past.
Cheers, mate.
You find a small hotel called the Flowering Heart in the middle of the foreign quarter that has a sign outside saying rooms available.
This looks nice. I like
it.
Hey, Beelzeboob, is this a place of repute or is it shit?
Yeah, what
no,
do you think?
It is a very good place to steal.
Yeah, what if we're going to stay there?
What if we're staying, yes.
Yes, it is a good place to steal.
Baba goes in.
Shania goes in.
I think we'll stay here. Yes.
That's it, Shania. We'll make decisions, yeah? Me and you.
Yeah, that's right. We're going to be decision makers, yeah?
Yeah.
All decisions. We're at the front of the staff.
By us.
What?
Huh?
So what, we are like decision or something?
Oh, yeah, we could call ourselves
Decisive.
Could you two stop standing in the doorway? I'm trying to get through to go and book us some rooms. So you're just standing there talking. Come on, it's time for action. And I push past.
There is an old lady with a handkerchief on her head sitting behind the table. There's a row of keys on the thing.
Hello, mate.
Behind her.
Oh,
sorry. She leans over it. Looks at you through her spectacles.
Hello. Hello. Sorry, Dan. Carry on, mate.
Yes.
He says,
hello there.
Yes.
We'd like some rooms.
Yeah, we would like to stay.
Now, welcome to the Flying Trellis. It's the most luxurious place to stay in the entire district.
I don't believe you, but that's fine.
How dare you?
I mean, it's not like we just came across the first place we did and then decided that's where to go stay.
Whatever. How much are the rooms?
I'll have to check my bookings.
She takes out a big book, opens it. It's completely empty. She stands looking through it for a moment, peering at her glasses, and she runs a finger down.
I think I can squeeze you in.
Yes.
Okay, good. How much are the rooms?
How long are you staying for?
Couple of
maybe
days.
Maybe 2-3 nights, who knows? Maybe longer.
Rent them for... rooms are rented with full room and board for a week at a time. Gold piece a room.
Yes, that's fine.
Okay, that's fine. Good. Let's go for this, okay?
Yes, yes.
Right. Beelzeboob, we've got an authority from you that this is, in fact, a great place to stay. Is that right? I don't know which word it was you said then or which language, but...
I think he's just choking to death. I'm not sure.
Yes,
okay,
this
here's
is
the gold coin. Give me a room key.
She takes the keys out. She gives each of you a room key and gives you a card with meal times on it.
Is it possible to have a bath? Do the rooms have facilities?
Fancy man wants a bath.
Well, we've just been at sea for weeks and weeks, and I like to wash me and my fox.
This.
What? Geez, very dirty. He is.
How dare you?
I'll go around to the wall.
There's no need to take that tone, madam.
All right, for the bath facilities, there's a silver piece.
Well, each time?
Yes.
Oh. Well, yeah,
how dirty is your fox that you need to wash it all the time?
I just wondered. All right, then, yes, I'm going to put a pin in that for the moment. Are we going out this evening?
You're going to put a pin in gin?
No.
Drain him, put him in a bath, and then stick a pin in him.
Look, I don't believe in animal cruelty. If you do, that is your issue. But
I've never said about putting a pin in a fox.
Are we going to see the Pathfinders? Or are we going to rest here for the night?
I thought we were going to see the Pathfinders. I feel very well rested. I'm good to go.
It's not nighttime, is it?
No, it's the
late afternoon.
Yeah, late afternoon.
Cool. Yeah, I'm just going to check on my shop before, just to see if Bang Bam Bam is looking after it well.
Is that on the way to the Pathfinders?
Yes.
Let's do both.
It's in the foreign quarter here.
Decisions.
Oh, the Pathfinder Lodge is here in the foreign quarter.
Yeah, you can show us the Pathfinder. We go there, you go check on your shop, okay? Sounds good to me.
Oh, we'll all just do it together.
Let's go.
Yes.
Let's go.
I'd like to see the shop.
I just head to the... where my shop is in the foreign court.
I'll see you later then.
See you later.
Yeah, okay, we'll be back later.
Okay, you make your way through the foreign quarter to Beelzeboobs and Beelzebits and Bobs. Is it? How's it spelled?
It's boot. It's bobs.
But right, not bits and boobs. Bits,
yeah,
bobs.
But he pronounces it right. Boobs. Yeah.
Okay. Sorry, because it was so clear.
God, don't be so dirty-minded.
But is the Pathfinder on the way to the shop, or is it...
No, it's a bit further on. So
it's further past the shop.
So let's pop in the shop
first.
Let's
pop in the shop.
All right.
Okay. Jump's like, I just want to get on with this.
You,
let's do something.
You find it. How consistent is the branding between this one and the Tamron?
It's a little bit different font. Oh, different okay. Font for the signs.
Right. Is it like going to a McDonald's in a different country? Like yeah. Different burgers?
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah.
So you've not got clear message in there, mate.
What do you mean?
Well, you've got two different fonts on go, haven't you? So.
Yes, well, it's only because I was thought of your different brand when I was... my first one.
Need to get them unified, mate, if you want a clear message that goes global.
Yeah, well, I haven't been here for like a year, so...
Still, that's what your regional manager is in charge. He's got to communicate that to you, otherwise.
Well, you'll see one of the finest regional managers when you enter this shop.
Well, I mean, you left a tiny. Okay,
let's meet him. I walk in.
Let's go in. Yeah, Baba goes in.
You're right in. It is an alchemy shop laid out. So there's a few potions and things set around. There is behind the table. There is a sort of looks like a statue with its hands just on the on the counter. As you get in, there's a grinding of stone as the statue turns its head to look at you. It's quite crudely carved, as if the person who carved it sort of isn't like a master sculptor.
That must be Mr. Bam Bam, I'm assuming.
Bam!
You are Bang Bam Bam?
Father, welcome home. Welcome to Beelzeboob Bits and Bobs. How can I help you all?
No, I just wanted to check on everything. Have you got the ledger, to see how well we've been doing?
Yes, Father. I will get it for you.
Thank you.
The statue turns with a horrible scraping noise of stone as it turns and then just sort of drags its feet across the floor over to a bookshelf, takes down a large ledger, and then scrapes ever... Like, it takes ages. Any one of you could have gone and got the book in that time and then lays it upon the table.
Like, what? If someone came in to try and steal something from the shop, she would never catch them.
Has there been any robberies?
Yes, Father.
How many?
There have been many. Every day.
And did you stop any of them?
Not yet, Father. But I am trying. I am learning. One day I will make you proud.
Yes,
you'll be losing money here, mate. You're losing much.
Your cruelty extends to living creatures and now golems.
This is what I'm thinking. It's because, you know, old Jam is your son, because technically it's made out of your blood and your flesh. So how is Bam Bam Bam?
Bang Bam Bam.
Is it bang bang, bang Bam Bam?
Bang Bam Bam. Bang, bang, bang,
bang. Oh, my deepest apologies. I am sorry that I have mistitled the golem. All right. How about Bang for short?
Yeah.
Why is Bang calling you the father?
Because they're all my children.
But you didn't make this one out of your own body. Well, or even from your loins either, so...
Yeah, but I just made him to say that.
You just make things tell
him
you're the daddy.
Yes.
It makes
them feel like they're part of a family.
And why did you program your golem with a sense of shame? I don't understand. It seems to radiate deep sorrow and shame and guilt.
No,
it's very odd.
It's just his voice.
He just said that it was sorry and it would do better.
Yeah, but it is fine. You have sorrow for the things you have done.
Yes, but at least I can move faster than 2 centimeters a second.
Well, anyway, do we need to pick anything else up here? Or?
Well, there's nothing here, is there? I mean, look, the shelves are empty.
It hasn't made me stoked.
It looks like the place has been ransacked.
Bang, bang.
Every day.
You haven't got an adamantine club just kicking back in the storeroom, have you?
No, I am sorry. I will try to do better.
No, it's all right. I'm not shaming you. Oh, can't you make them less weird?
So I look at the ledger
bang,
and
bang,
I look...
Bang, bang, hangs its head in shame.
I look at the ledger and I look at how much money has been made.
The shop has been running at a considerable loss. It is robbed regularly, and none of the goods are being recovered. The insurance policy has long since stopped being paid.
Yes, good work.
I think we should rename the shop to Beelzebub's Nothing and Dust, because it's pretty much what you've got left.
Yeah.
Oh, and a very sad golem.
So, I give him 10 gold pieces. Go out and buy some stock, and restock, Yeah, actually, I'll give you 50 gold pieces. Get some protection as well.
I'm interested, Beelzeboob. How does one go about buying bits and bobs? I mean, do you just randomly buy things?
I suppose you've got to spend money to make money.
I'm sorry, Bang. Where will you put this gold upon your person?
I will get a bag. He turns and just very slowly starts scraping his way along the floor.
Just Caragor's having
just
an aneurysm.
Be careful, don't let anyone sees the bag, because they will take it from you.
A golem which can't move faster than like a frog with leprosy out into the streets of the busiest city with a satchel after having established that it can't fend for itself and protect against robberies. And you've given it 50 gold pieces!
Yes. It will motivate him to do better.
Why are you trying to motivate him to do better? He's a golem. Why don't you give him the feelings in the first place? Why don't you just sell the golem, recoup some of your losses, close the fucking shop, mate?
No, that would be silly. How can I franchise?
You're right. That's the silly one. That's the silly one. You're correct. My bad. It must be the eye patch.
Come on.
I tell you what, Caragor. You clearly don't understand business. And
frankly, judging
by the shop,
neither
do I.
I shall be back sometime in the future. Do well, my son.
Well, now there's a threat.
Captain Vague. Okay, good. Okay, so let's go to the Pathfinder. I don't want to tell you how to live your life. Just you're a fucking idiot. Okay, let's go.
I bet you're really glad Shania came this way. You're convinced it's coming this way.
I would love to see Shania on Dragon's Den. That would be the best.
It's a fucking stupid idea.
Jam Jam looks up.
Brother.
Bam 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 goes, brother. They stare at each other for a moment.
Glad to see you're doing as well as always.
And then takes Velda's hand and walks out.
What, did Jam Jam just lead you outside? Like a horrible meaty date.
I suppose I'm going out now.
Come, Uncle Velda.
Oh. Right, to the Pathfinders.
He will fail you, father. He will never make you proud like I will.
Yes, you are my sons, and you have made me very proud.
You head off down the street. Bang, Bam Bam is still struggling with a back in 3 hours sign that he's trying to hang on the door. With the satchel around his waist. And you make your way to the Grand Lodge, the Grand Pathfinder Lodge. It's a huge complex of buildings with the great symbol of the open road on the gates, which is the Pathfinder symbol. It's very easy to see. So it's a big sign up there, and there are various people hanging around. The gates are open, and there are lots of figures kind of hanging around it. You ask around, and you are sent to a sort of general waiting area. Where people can go if they have problems that the Pathfinders might be able to deal with. And you're told to wait. After a little while, a rat folk comes wandering over to you. He is wearing a sort of greenish cloak with the hood up, a heavy-looking backpack stuffed full of all sorts of gadgets and things, and he has a short sword at his side. How's it going? Hey, I hear you need the Pathfinders?
Yeah, that's right. Yes. We have something to discuss for them.
I mean, the fact that we're here is probably a clue.
That's why I sort of assumed that. Okay, well, you're doing good because you found us. Hey!
What is your name?
Good, okay.
My name's Henry Time.
Is that Time with a YM? Or?
No.
Are we still out in a corridor?
You're like in a waiting area.
There are other people waiting.
Yeah, there's loads of people around.
Okay. Well, before we discuss this, I think we should go somewhere very private, yeah?
Hold a moment. Who is this person? He looks like he's about to head out the door.
He says he's a Pathfinder.
Yeah. I know, but we don't want to speak to anyone.
Now, we're in the Pathfinder. You might just be a receptionist.
Are you the receptionist?
All right, fine. Whatever. It's a fuck. Just if we want to discuss what we want to discuss, somewhere in private. He's saying he's Pathfinder. So, we want to discuss stuff.
Yeah, that's right. I remembered the Pathfinder.
Yeah, but I think we should speak to someone. How important are you in the Pathfinders?
I feel like I'm pretty important. You know, we're all important to somebody.
Yes, and what rank? How important are you in the society?
Well, I'm a member of the society.
Right, he's not important at all. Can we speak to somebody important, please? Can you go and get someone important?
That's right, you've met Veldekern Black, there you go. Yes. It's usually how it goes the first time you've met him.
Yes.
Hey, look, we get a lot of people like that. If you need to hire the Pathfinders for something, you've got something, you can submit a form, and, you know, we'll get to it when we can.
No. We have something of great importance that we wish to discuss with the Pathfinders. We need
information. Well, that's what I'm here for. I'm here to talk, if you want.
Okay, fine. Then let's go somewhere private, and let's talk. Let's do this now.
Oh.
Do you know where Venture Captain Ambrose Valsin is?
Yes, he's away on assignment at the moment.
But who the fuck you are? What's the fuck? Where is this coming from? Who is this you're asking for?
It's the leader of the Pathfinder.
You did not think to mention this before when we talk about the Pathfinders. You talk about everyone except him. The fuck is wrong with you? Jesus, fuck. Fucking car!
We went to your shop and watched Horrible Families for about 2 hours, and now you mentioned the most important person, the Pathfinder, in the area.
Why did you not tell us?
Team, lots of people looking, Sorry.
Sorry. I find I'm just
we don't want to draw too much attention to ourselves, man.
Okay.
I just thought it was you didn't mention.
Beelzeebub, you've got to be a bit clearer next time, brother.
About
what I mean?
Everything you were talking about, the Archlords, about the Spirocus.
Weeks talking about this very day.
I was busy thinking up new formulas.
Okay.
Frustration is there, but
I see you, Beelzeebub. I see you.
So, what's the name? Say the name again.
The Venture Captain. Ambrose Valison.
Okay, Venture Cameron. Okay, this guy. Can you find this guy for us, please?
He's not here at the moment.
Where is he?
He's away on assignment. He's one of the heads of the Pathfinders.
Right.
So just take meetings with anybody.
That's fair enough. Who is the Pathfinder immediately underneath him in the hierarchy?
Yeah.
Would it be captain?
Or someone of equal.
Or venture lieutenant?
There's plenty of venture captains, but. I mean, I guess I could ask around, see if I can find a venture captain who was...
Yeah, just check the logistics who signed in to work today.
Anyone, we'd like to talk to them now.
We would like to stress this is a matter of extreme importance, and we've travelled a very, very long way to come and speak to you. So if you could find someone important, not that I'm saying you're not important.
Nobody who comes to the Pathfinder Society says that when they come in. That's you're unique in thinking that your problem's the biggest problem in the world. I had somebody told me that the other day. Turned out they had like a dog. Stuck in a tree.
Listen, buddy.
I'm sorry.
Just,
are you
just okay? Great.
Go and find someone.
I do apologise for our brusqueness, Henry. Time. We do appreciate your time. You are valued as part of the Pathfinders, I'm sure, and you will be valued for us if you complete this very small task for us. If it would help, and I know you don't take bribes, would 2 silver pieces help you on your way?
Yeah, sure.
There you go.
All right. Let's go for that. I'll go ask around, see if I can find somebody.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
It might take a while, though. Yeah.
I feel like really part of the team.
What, because we are very frustrated with you?
Tug Beelzeebub just to the side. Look, man, you've got to be a bit clearer. Like, these little, I don't know if you've noticed, but it's like well pissed off of you.
Translating five minutes of screaming.
You're hanging by a thread, son. just keep it like on a level,
talk more.
I like you, yeah.
Help.
We're old friends, kind of. You know, we fought a snake.
You can vouch for me, of course.
I can, but I haven't got much ball. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah,
thank you. You see how them two were just leering right off like that could have been your head. Do you know what I mean?
Really?
They're crazy. They're
but
crazy.
You would protect me, of course.
I mean. Look,
we are the greatest of friends.
I protect you. I don't know about the greatest.
The fuck you two whispering about now? No, What's going on?
I'm just saying, like,
is
he's
this,
got.
Is this why Beelzeebub was on Johnny Pike? Just to split it apart? Like, he's got, like the poison chalice. Just
like, it's like that guy in Civil War, isn't it?
Yeah.
No, I was just getting him involved, just making sure that he tells us the information that he's got now.
Yeah, okay. It's good advice. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Because otherwise, yeah.
Listen, sorry that I shouted at you. I just, I've got my temper is on the not long. It's not long, my temper.
It's on the not long.
Yeah.
It's honestly not
on a scale of one to short, it's
not long.
Not long, yes.
Yes, I'm sorry. I should have told you that the venture captain was this man.
It's fine. It's not even here anyway, so...
Yeah, I mean, God. It's really annoying,
We
actually.
Have to make sure that whoever comes, is trustworthy as well. How
well, this is why I think we should speak to someone important, you see,
not necessarily. That's the most important point, since the most trustworthy, you know. Basically, the Pathfinders are the only possibilities that we can talk to. We will have to judge character as we meet, you know?
I mean, we...
What is this thing you keep talking about?
Caragor goes over to someone else waiting in the waiting room.
There's an old man sat patiently waiting. He's been there about the same amount of time you have.
Hello.
Hello.
You're right, what's your name?
My name is Gavarin.
Hello, Gavarin. Yeah, that's weird. I met a Gavarin earlier.
We met a Gavarin earlier.
Yeah, it must be a common name.
Second Gavarin we've met.
There's a lot of Gavarins around.
I'm Caragor. Hey, what are you here for, Gavarin? Who are you trying to see?
Why do you need to know that?
Oh, we're waiting for someone to come back to us, so I'm just killing time. Having a bit of a... Just wondering, you see, if we've missed out any names or anybody like that.
I'm here on a mission of utmost importance.
Oh, cracking, yes.
Secrecy.
What have you got? I bet.
What's
happened?
Why are you asking such questions? Just wondering when I can trust you.
Maybe we can help.
Because we are part of the Pathfinder Society.
What the... I came over by myself.
Oh, sorry. I was just listening to you.
You went over your own, and Bubba's followed you.
Yeah, weirdly, I'm all right with Bubba doing it, but not you.
You are my friend.
So, Gavarin,
yes.
this mission of utmost importance, what is it? What you got to do?
Why do you need to know that?
Because maybe I can help. We can pool resources. Maybe you can help us with ours.
No, this isn't right. This isn't right at all.
Honestly, Gavarin, I'm a friend. Can I persuade him?
Go try, yeah.
With, what is that, a diplomacy?
It would be, yes. Trying to improve his attitude towards you.
26.
26. I mean, I suppose it... Maybe it could. There's this fellow at my work.
Yeah.
And I think he's a member of the Whispering Way.
Oh, how'd you know that?
It's just something about him. Something suspicious. I think that he's plotting against the entire city.
Really?
Do you have any evidence for that, Gavarin?
I see him sort of mumbling to himself, and he's speaking in tongues, speaking in strange languages.
What is his name?
His name's Caiador.
Caiador, what's his last name?
Caiador Greenspring.
That's
a Whispering Way name if ever I heard it, right?
Sound a bit, have you been to the Pathfinder Society often before, Gavarin?
I come here a lot.
Yeah, lots of people who mumble to themselves in foreign languages.
I'm one of their top spies, helping them find members of the Whispering Way.
We're in quite a big city, aren't we? There's probably a lot of languages being spoken, isn't
there? Someone's in there not speaking common. There's something about that, isn't there?
Yeah, I see that. Thank you very much,
Thank
Gavarin.
Thank you very much, Gavarin. Have a good day.
Good luck with it, mate. Yeah.
Just isn't the idea of a spy not to say that they're a spy to people they've only just met?
No, but you're Pathfinder, so you're going to help me, right? You're going to... You're gonna kill the Greenspring for me?
Whoa!
I don't know.
Kill?
Yeah.
That's a bit. You jumped to murder quite quickly there. Is that what a Pathfinder would do?
It's not murder. He's Whispering Way. He's trying to bring. He's a terrorist.
I think you need to relax.
Yeah. Not everyone's a terrorist, mate.
Yeah, that's really.
No, not everyone is. Not people like you and me. But they are.
Yeah, all right.
Wait, hang on. What?
You understand what I mean, don't you?
Would you mean people like you and you mean you and the, is he a human?
Yes.
So you are the human and the Kenku.
It means like Pathfinders, I think.
People who believe in, you know, it's us. It's us. There's us. And then there's the elves.
Caragor just looks to wherever Shania is and goes, so anyway, that's pretty much all we've got. Good luck, I guess you've got to push you over
guys,
that way
who
now.
Who are you talking to?
Nothing, Shania.
Hey.
Oh.
I like it when you say my name that way.
Yeah, Shania, let's go this way. Let's go sit over here.
Yeah,
chair?
How long do you think we've got to have to wait to talk to
this guy? It's taking ages.
Can we skip forward in time?
If only that was an ability in real life.
Unless you can just
skip forward to completion of the quest.
Yeah, it's called sleeping.
Yes.
So you wait several more hours, the sun sets, After a while, Henry Time comes back.
I did some inquiries, and there should be a. They think there'd be a venture captain free to talk to you in maybe a couple of days.
Couple of days.
When's your man coming back? Who we said about earlier? Who my colleague said about earlier?
I mean, I don't know. I don't have access to somebody that important.
Okay, so who is it that will be around in a couple of days?
I don't know. It would just be that's when next time there's a venture captain available to speak with you.
It could be any venture. Okay, fine. Okay, all right. Thanks for your time.
I'm sure it's nothing I can help with.
Oh, it's just this is why I prefer being out of the wild, lads. Those bloody bureaucracy is pain in the head.
We get a lot of people coming in here, and everyone who comes in here says that their problem is the biggest problem in the world.
Well, I was just talking to your mate Gavron down there.
Not again.
Yeah. And obviously, just from the way you talked just then, Henry, I know you know his problem's not real, so why don't you just stop him from coming in, and that'll cut down your waiting list by about 40%.
Yeah, but what if one day he's right? You gotta look into these things, you know? You can't just turn people away because the problem sounds crazy. I mean, look at you. You're a group of people. You say you've got a problem that's of global importance, but you won't say what it is. And
you know what? Let's talk to Henry Time. Come on. There's not going to be a venture captain here for 2 days. Come on. Maybe he can help, or maybe he can put us in touch with someone. He needs to know what's going on.
Is enough time for me and Philippe to start our rival gangs, and also for me to get on stage in the Ivy District. I don't know. What do you think, lads?
We're going to speak to Winsell as well.
To be honest, I know that the 2 days isn't that long, but time could be of the essence with regards to this.
We should go to the Arcanium. Quest.
And, the Arcanium?
No.
Why do you love the Arcanium so much?
Well,
is there another very important named character that you haven't told us about yet?
Maybe.
That's his friend lives there, doesn't he?
No, he doesn't live there. He is a retired captain.
Well, what's the benefit of going to this Arcanium if we can't, if we can just wait a couple of days for the Pathfinder?
It depends. You said you needed information of the Arcana variety for whatever this strange thing that you're talking about.
I've advised to talk to Henry here and anyone that you're talking about right now.
It's also, we said that we don't want to go to the Arcanium since then. We said it initially, but then we said it a couple of times that we don't need to go there, we're going to Pathfinders instead. So why are you still trying to get us to go to the Arcanium?
There's only so much I can stick up for you, B. You know what I mean?
It's just odd. What? It's just odd, that's all. What was your previous job before you started your own shop? What did you do before then?
I was a student.
Where?
In Nex. I was learning the ways of Arcana, but I didn't really want to do magic. I wanted to use my abilities of mutagens and elixirs. And then I blew a hole in the side of the school, and they basically said, "Hey, Beelzebub, we don't want you here anymore." So then I traveled to Absalom, and then I was created a shop, and then I helped clear some of the beasts from the precipice district.
I insight check everything. I'm watching him. I'm seeing you so closely on here, everything he's saying.
Go ahead and make a perception check.
18.
An 18.
I'm not lying.
All right, okay, I'm bored now.
Let's just speak to time.
No, I understand that maybe not everyone is in agreement with this. Cargo, you have other things maybe we would like to do in the town.
No, I'm not right. Let's talk to him. Wait, Henry.
Yeah.
I bet you hear this a lot, don't you? Can we trust you?
Of course you can trust me. I'm a Pathfinder.
Perception insight check. Yeah. Natural one. I'm looking at my wrong eye.
Can I also do a...
Yeah, sure.
You got 23 from Bubba. Which is lucky.
It's 19.
19, not sure. Bubba, you feel like you can probably trust this guy?
Do you know what?
Pretty straight up.
I think this guy's pretty legit.
Okay, let's go. Let's speak to him.
Have we got some private
that we can go to chat?
Step into my office.
Okay, good.
Come on in. I'm sorry it smells. I'm brewing my own beer. So it's... He's got sort of a barrel in the corner.
Yeast.
Stinks of yeast.
Oh, I love the smell of yeast.
It's yeasty, huh?
I did not know this about you, should I?
Yes. Nothing quite like it.
Is it ready to drink?
Oh, yeast.
You want to smell the hops?
Oh, please, yeah.
Yeah, look, he takes some hops. Look at that. Give that a sniff.
Oh, it's so savory.
It's pretty good, huh?
Oh.
It's pretty hop.
Mm. What are you going to call this beer?
I'm going to call it Drinking Time. You know, because my name is Time. Wait, there's a better...
That works. No, that's good. Very good.
Okay. Listen. This is really of utmost importance.
Right.
This is very secret. And if it's above your station, then we need to have your word.
Right.
That this will go no further than you, Henry.
Right. All right. Wait, you want me to promise that I'm not going to tell anybody else in the Pathfinder Society?
That's not really what I'm saying.
Exactly.
What I'm saying is,
if you may need to tell someone else.
Yeah.
But.
Right.
But we're trusting you because we know that this is one of the most. This is a big problem for the world. Okay.
Right.
Right. And we might need to get someone else involved, but we need to trust you initially that you won't just go and tell anyone, that you'll go to the highest authority that you can get to and bring them in on this. Because you need to see that this is a problem, right? Because everyone else is coming in with cats and dogs up trees or whatever. This isn't that. This is real. Right. Okay? Are you in?
I might be. Give me a diplomacy check. See how good convincing you are.
It's a 14.
All right. Well, I do my best. Like I say, we're pretty busy, but I'll do what I can to help.
Velda, do you have the shard?
Well, should we relay?
Presumably you do.
I do. Should we just
imagine if he didn't?
Perhaps we should establish some context.
Let's fill him in. Yeah.
So should we just fill him in about all where we got it, what happened
before we start talking,
all that sort of stuff?
Caragor shuts the door.
Yep.
Walks patiently around the room, checks every crevice. Are there any windows or any gaps anywhere? Is the wood very thick? Everything. Is
paintings,
there any
perception? Yeah. Sure.
26.
So the room is stone. It has wooden floorboards.
Mm-hmm.
There is a single window, but you are on the third floor, so you're some way up. It's quite a small window.
Floorboards underneath. Is there any trapdoors or?
There are no trapdoors, no.
Okay. And the door itself that we closed just now to this room is wood?
Yeah.
Okay. And is it lockable?
It is. It needs a key, and you don't seem to have.
Don't need to lock it. That'd be weird. How thick is the door?
It's solid. It's not like a sort of bank vault, but yeah.
Well, that should be fine as long as we don't shout. Caragor takes a look out the window and sees what he can see around.
So you're looking out on the courtyard where you first came into the Pathfinder Lodge.
Right.
So Velda, presumably with everyone else, just relays the whole story of what happened.
Yep.
When it comes to talking about the shard, mm-hmm. he doesn't necessarily speak about how powerful it is, just that we're wondering what it is.
Okay.
And obviously it's quite important, but I don't, because he's probably not magical, I don't go like, it's insanely powerful magic, though. Just literally kind of almost downplay it a little bit.
It's more like, why have these people gone to such lengths to keep this away from, you know what I mean?
Exactly.
And why would Razmir be looking for it, and why would the Whispering Tyrant be looking for it?
That's fascinating. You're saying you made a chili without any of the fundamental ingredients of a chili?
Yeah, it was very challenging for me, but I rose to the challenge.
It's not the biggest part of the story.
No, I think you're focusing on the wrong thing. As we say, why the such length?
Sorry,
to
it was a really
this?
Detailed story.
It was, yeah.
Right, sorry, right, so you got this piece of glass, and it's magical, huh?
Yeah.
Well, it certainly seems to be important. People have gone to a lot of effort about it. Have you ever heard of anything like it?
It came from a very powerful blood mage and was being passed on to Razmir, and the Whispering Tyrant is looking for it.
Ah, yeah, and also, by the relaying the story, it's the Master Living God. I don't be like, and we killed Uncle Gooden, and he was a blood mage. Like, we're going to leave that bit out.
Cool.
I think it's probably best.
Because
we are wanted big time.
Well, all right.
So I don't think we should mention Uncle Gooden unless anyone particularly.
But we got it from. But we have to say we got it from a blood mage.
No, we didn't. We got a lead from there, but we followed a lead, all and then. Right. But also, we're not. That's not.
You killed a bloke mage. You took it from them. You found out they were linked to the.
We followed a lead to the Master Living God. That's where I'm starting the story.
Leave the bloke mage out.
Yeah.
Cool. Okay.
Because they're still looking for us, I'm sure.
No problem. All right. Well. This sounds pretty serious. I guess. I mean, I don't know much about magic, but maybe I could look into it. I could ask around, do a bit of reading in the library, see what I can come up with for you. How's that sound, fellas?
Garagor looks at Velda. Could we have access to that library?
I mean, I'd love to look at the library, yeah.
I'd have to submit an application for you to join the Pathfinders. It'll take a few days to go through.
Could I just look at it as a visitor?
Well, I mean,
if you escorted me, I wouldn't be alone.
We don't just let anybody into the... That was pretty scary what you just did there.
I'm sorry, what? I enjoyed it. Well done, Jam, good. I'll pat his little sticky head.
What happens? Hey, Henry, has this place ever been attacked?
The lodge, yeah.
Yeah, what happens to people who attack the lodge?
Well, the Pathfinders defend it.
Yeah, do they ever take prisoners?
Why would you say that? That's
just wondering
vaguely threatening.
I'm just wondering what its defensive capabilities are.
Why do you need to know that?
Because, well, we spent a few minutes talking about how important the mission is, but yes, I am actually wondering now, if I attack the Pathfinder Lodge, would I get to see your superiors quicker than to join the actual Pathfinders?
Whoa, all right, that's enough, fellas. I'm going to do some... I'll do some looking into this for you, but you're not filling me with confidence, frankly, about... you're talking about attacking the Pathfinder Lodge.
Caragor's just, he's got a military mind. He's always just asking questions.
All right.
Well, if you could just ask very subtly about this.
I'll do some asking around
Because honestly, we went through so much bother to get this, and I don't want to be put in danger for this, Mr. Time, because you seem a decent fellow.
Where are you staying? I'll let you know when I hear something.
Why don't we come back in a couple of days?
Yeah, we will come back to you.
We'll come back to you.
All right, well.
Okay.
You take care of yourselves, fellas.
You take care as well. Okay.
Thank you.
Let's go.
All right. You head out of the Pathfinder Lodge, having had a slightly frustrating meeting. Made a little progress. You make your way out of the lodge and back down the streets, back towards where your own room is. When you pass a poster labeled up on the wall, advertising a concert going on, a musical gig taking place, and the sign, the name on it reads Fleet Wing and Scripps.
Pumpy Scripps.
On the poster, there is a picture of a Tengu holding a banjolele similar to Bubba's, and next to him is a picture of another figure. What does the other figure look like, Colin?
Pumpy Scripps there with her blonde hair has just... joined another band.
She's on a band called Fleet Wing and Scripps, and they are playing tonight at the Nest, and that is where we leave it for tonight.
Oh, I smell backstory.
Well.
Good morning, good evening, good afternoon, whatever time you're listening to this, Dangerlings. Thank you so much again for listening to this week's episode and every episode that you've listened to. You are what makes this podcast great. Thank you so, so much. Now, we just wanted to have a little conversation at the end of this episode because we're all going through something right now. The whole world is going through COVID-19 and it's affecting us all. So it's a really hard time for some people. So if you need to connect with someone, get on our Discord. Honestly, the network that is arising from that channel is just fantastic. We've got so many people on there just bigging each other up, just taking care of each other. We're all on there. The Danger Club are on there. We get involved in the conversations and the giggles and the laughs and stuff like that, which is great. And it's just a really nice network. So if you need someone to reach out to right now, seriously, come on the Discord and have a chat to us. Dangerlings are now setting up games with other Dangerlings, which is so amazing. There's a sub channel on there called Club, and you can go on there and you can get involved, and hopefully you can play maybe a Starfinder game or a Pathfinder game with other Dangerlings, which is so, so lovely that that's happening. Also, we just want to big up everyone that works for any care system across the world right now. The NHS obviously is the one that we have in England, but every care system across the world, care workers, you are just doing the most amazing, beautiful work, and we can't thank you enough. There's someone on our Discord right now, and he is helping build and put together the NHS hospital up in Manchester, which is amazing. John Herrin, thank you so much, and thank you to all the NHS workers, and as I say, every care system across the world right now. If you are listening, you are a beautiful, beautiful human being. Thank you so much. Much love to you.